Sometimes after listening to such a long gospel reading, especially with this one that is so self-explanatory, if I can say, your heart is already touched. You already have a message there in your heart. So I know that as you are listening to me already in the gospel, Jesus has spoken to you. Some lines there have touched you already. So in a few minutes left, I'll try to bring those things that were running through our minds as we were reading the gospel. Number one is that you know that going to Samaria, or rather going to Galilee from Judea, you have to pass through Samaria. This one we almost all know that. Because Samaria was between Judea and Galilee. If I read verses 1 of chapter 4, which we are reading now, we have been told that Jesus was moving from Judea going to Galilee in the north, but he had to decide whether to pass through Samaria or to walk around it. We are also told that if you were a holy man, if you're a good woman, you're a good man, and you were going from Judea in the down to Galilee in the north, you don't go through Samaria. Rather walk around it or go around it, because the people in Samaria were noted to be bad, were noted to be evil, so people wanted to avoid them. And here comes Jesus, our Savior and our Lord, and he is going to Galilee. Instead of behaving like us, who would have walked around Samaria, he went straight into it. He decided to walk through Samaria, not to walk around it. As we sit here, we are all Samarians of some kind. People avoid us because of some reasons. Some people bypass you, walk by you, you know, certain things you are not considered, you are put away, certain place. So we have many Samarians in our days now, people who are rejected, not cared for, and some of us are even Samarians in ourselves. People are avoiding us, we feel lonely. Yet we are told that Jesus, instead of behaving like us, avoiding people, decided to walk through Samaria. And why did he walk through Samaria? Because there was this woman who needed salvation. If Jesus, if he has to decide to walk through your Samaria, he will come to you. Amen. This is encouraging because it means that even when you have given up on yourself, when your family has given up on you, friends have given up on you, Jesus will not give up on you. Amen. He didn't give up on that woman. He went through the town just to make sure that that woman is touched. Thank God he did so, because as you know, the end of the story now, the woman was changed totally. Do you need Jesus to walk through your Samaria? Lent is the period. In Lent, we have to allow him to walk through our Samaria. Some of us, like the woman began in the beginning, we want to avoid him. We don't want him to walk through our Samaria because we are afraid that if he walks through our Samaria, what he will see, what he will hear, so we want to push him away. Yet he wants to come to you. May this Lenten season, may we see it as a way of Jesus trying to walk into our lives, into our Samarias. Things we don't want people to hear, things we don't want to see, but we know that they are not good, they are not pleasant. These are the Samarias Jesus wants us to open up to him this Lenten season. So he walks through Samaria, he meets this woman, and initially she didn't like him, maybe. She didn't welcome him, maybe. But she felt the need to keep him in the conversation. She started calling him, you a man, you know, coming to prophet, say, and then savior of the world. Our knowledge of Jesus has to be growing. If you listen carefully, she started by calling him, you a man. Then somewhere she started calling him, say. Then somewhere again, the same passage, started calling him what? Prophet. And then she ended by calling him the Savior, Christ. So she had graduated in the knowledge of Jesus from minute to minute. I think we are in the third week of Lent. It's supposed to be 5-6 weeks plus Holy Week. I don't know whether your knowledge of God this Lent is graduating, or it's still, you know him as a man, or you know him as Sir, or you know him just as a prophet. Jesus is more than a man. He's more than Sir. He's more than a prophet. He's the Christ. He's anointed of God. I pray that before we end this Lenten season, you and I will come to that full knowledge of God, or more so, better knowledge of God. Let us not see him as a man there, as somebody to be called sir, somebody to call prophet, but let's see him as our Savior, the Christ. With the same passage, you realize that the woman said, give me some of the water, but I want to go and come back again. And that is me, actually, in that passage. And that is you. We have waters that we have been drinking that never satisfy us. So we are being reminded this Lenten season to look for those waters that are not satisfactory. You drink them today and then tomorrow you drink again because they don't satisfy us. The waters of sin. You heard that in the first reading. The Israelites were in the desert and they wanted to drink something. Because of water, they were getting angry. God instructed his servant Moses to give them water. Some of us, we are drinking spiritual dirty waters because of our way of life, our attitudes, because of what we are into. Jesus wants us to drink living water this Lent. Amen. It is time for you to put away that dirty water you have been drinking. That dirty water of anger, of hatred, of lust, of you know that. Sinners, we know them better. Let us put away those dirty waters and ask for the living water, which will be forever. She required, she needed this water. And that alone made her kept talking to Jesus. So let us look out this land for the waters that are not satisfactory. Those things that we take in every day spiritually, our habits, our actions, we know that they are not good yet, we are still taking them in. Those are the waters we need to push away. The last one, then I'm done. We are told that when the woman had encountered Jesus now, she had to run to the village. But she did something. She had come to the well with her water jar to do what? To fetch water. And yet, after encountering Jesus, she runs to the village, leaving her water jar behind. That is the message. This is the message. You have to leave your water jar behind. If Lent is 3 weeks now, 4, 5, 6, and it's done, and you are still carrying your water jars, my dear sister, my dear brother, my dear friend, mother, father, you have not gotten that reconciliation. In Lent, we learn to drop our water jars. Drop them. You don't need them. Just drop them down. If you encounter Jesus, there's no need to carry around the water jars. Unfortunately, sinners, as we know ourselves, we still want to keep them around, you know? So we want to sip from them once a while. You know they are not good, they are giving us weight, they have become excess baggage, and yet, please, drop your water jars. This is the message of the Lenten season. You have to learn to drop the water jars in your life. You don't need them. You need Jesus. May this encounter of Jesus and the Samaritan woman be our encounter this Lent. Jesus is coming to your Samaria. You make sure that he doesn't leave you the same. This Lent, he intends to touch you and touch you for good. Amen.